श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं। ओम सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं। ओम आप्यायन्तु ममांगानि वाक्प्राणश्चक्षुः श्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्मोपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यात् मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्तु अनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते ये उपनिषत्सु धर्माः ते मयि सन्तु। ओम शांति शांति शांति। इन 12th सेक्शन 12th सेक्शन ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर प्रथमाध्यायस्य द्वादशकण्डः वी आर गोइंग टू see a special mantra called Shauva Gita Udgita. Shauva Udgita. Shauva. Shauva means what? This actually word derived from Shva. Shva means dog. So this mantra was given by a dog, Udgita, Shauva mantra. And along with puppies. So, this is going to be revealed by the dog and the dogs also. If it is called Shauva Udgita. Now, here Udgita means what? Normally, Udgita means what? Sama Avayava Bhakti. Is it not? Visa. Udgita also Sama Avayava Bhakti. But in this context, Udgita means Sama Mantra only. Sama Mantra only. So, here Shauva Sama Mantra. This is one. Okay. Now, Acharya Shankara mentions in this, now itself I am telling you, that these dogs actually are not dogs. A Rishi who has come in the form of a dog in order to bless a Vedic student who has been practicing Samaveda. So the story also will come. So, or Acharya Shankara gives another alternative is, it could be Prana Devata. Prana Devata, that she might have come in the form of a dog to teach this particular Samaveda student. Okay. Now, why this is given? What is the phalam? Here the prayer is involved in this section. The prayer is for Anna Samriddhi. Anna Samriddhi. So Acharya Shankara says, in the previous section, we saw how the Ushasti suffered for food. Is it not? See that Atita Kande Anna Prapti Nimitta Kashta Avastha Uktaha उच्छिष्ट पर्युषित भक्षण लक्षण सा मा भूत इति अन्नलाभाय अन्नलाभाय अथ अनंतरम शौवः स्वभिर्दृष्टः उद्गीत उद्गानम सामातः प्रस्तूयते. सी बिकॉज द प्रॉब्लम द डिफिकल्टी विच वाज विच सीन और फेस्ड बाय उशस्ति इन गेटिंग अन्न एंड सब्सिक्वेंटली हैड टू अंडरगो टू डू टू दोषास फॉल्ट्स व्हाट आर दे उच्छिष्ट भोजनम एंड परिषित भोजनम ही हैड टू ईट. So, ma bhut, let such kind of a problems should not occur. So, keeping that in view, this section is helping us for anna samruddhi, so that one need not violate the dharma, okay, of eating inferior quality food, uchishta bhojanam, inferior quality also, plus then parishitam, next day morning also he ate same thing. So, this should not be the case. So similar problem should not be faced. That is a prayer, that is a wish in this shloka, in this section. Now what is the story we will see? Now we'll chant the first five mantras, all five mantras only we'll chant together. Atha ataha shauva udgitah tadha bako dalbhyah ग्लावो वा मैत्रेयः स्वाध्यायम् उद्वव्राज तस्मै श्वा श्वेतः प्रादुर्बभूव तम् अन्ये श्वान उपसमेत्य ऊचुः अन्नं नो भगवान् आगायतो अशनायाम वा इति तान् होवाच इह एव मा प्रातः उपसमीयात इति तदह बको दाल्भ्यः ग्लावो वा मैत्रेयः प्रतिपालयाञ्चकार तेह यथा एव इह बहिष्पवमानेन स्तोष्यमानाः संरब्धाः सर्पन्ति इति एवम् आसस्पृहो आससृपुहो तेह समुपविश्य हिं चक्रुः किं चक्रुः ओम अदामा ओम पिबामा ओम देवो वरुण प्रजापतिः सविता अन्नमिह आहरा अन्नपते अन्नमिह आहरा आहर ओम इति. Okay, now the student is Bakaha. Here the student, Vedic student, is Bakaha Nama, and he has other names also. How other names are Dalbhyaha, Glavaha and Maitreyaha. So these are all the names, is it not? Bako Dalbhyaha, Glavova, Maitreyaha. Swadhyayam Udvravraja. Now somebody asked a question. How all the four names are equal to same person? How can you say? Here two gotras are mentioned. All the four names are one only. Two gotras. In Acharya Bhashya it comes that a daughter whose husband is no more, and the daughter gave birth to a son, of course, and the husband died. The son, gotra, son is adopted by the grandfather, by Nanaji also. So he becomes two gotras, right? And he has four names. How can you say all the four names belonging to 1%, one person only? Because we have to watch the verb here. Shankaracharya says, you watch the verb of the sentence. Verb says ut, ut vavraja. Ut vavraja means the ut shabda is a singular verb. It's a singular verb. The verb is singular, subject also must be singular. Is it not? Verb is plural, subjects are plural. But here, verb is singular, therefore all the four names belong to same person only. So, we can use Bakaha as an easy name. Dalbhyaha, Glavaha, Maitreya, bigger names. So, we remember, we keep this as a name, Bakaha. So, Bakaha was a student of Samaveda. And he used to practice every day, whatever it is. Okay. So the student is going to do Samaveda Adhyayanam. He wanted to go and sit under nearby a river, lake. And on his way, right, he saw a dog, white dog. He was going to a nadi kinare, to the bank of the river or lake, just to sit there and practice Samaveda. He is a great practitioner, Vedic student. On the way, he saw a white dog. And white dog, as I told you, Acharya Shankara says, is either a Rishi or a Prana Devata in that form, white dog form. And because why? Rishi was pleased with the sincerity of the student, Vedic student. So they thought, Prana Devata, Rishi, they thought that we will bless now the student, I will bless the student. Because he has been very sincere to his practices. Okay. So they came in the form of a white dog. And this Baka was going to some kinaret for chanting of Sama Veda Abhyasa. Now when the white dog was there, as he was watching the white dog, some more little small dogs came there, puppies. They all surrounded the big dog, main dog, white dog. And they said, oh Lord, these dogs asked the white dog. Oh Lord, eh Bhagavan, what is the mantra? He says, Tan ho vachaya eva ma prataha. No, so, Tan ho tasmai shwa svetaha pradur babhuva tam anye shwan upasametya. Other dogs having approached him, uchuhu, they said, annam no Bhagavan agayato ashana yamavajiti. See? These dogs have asked him, sir, oh, please sing Sama Mantra for us. Why? If you sing Sama Mantra, we get plenty of annam. So do some Sama Mantra chanting, we get plenty of annam, anna samruddhi. Please sing for the sake of the food, we are very hungry. Ashanayama, we are very hungry, so please sing this mantra, Sama Mantra for us. And therefore, the white dog said, this is not the right time. He said, dog, what did dog say? Tan ho vacha iha eva ma prataha upasamiyata iti. Dog said, this is not the right time to chant Sama Mantra. You come to me and meet me early morning in the same place, tomorrow morning. Morning you come on time, same place. I will teach you, I will sing Sama Mantra for you. Now, from this Shankaracharya ji, Acharya Shankara gives Bhashya. He mentions that means, very important thing is that, it is an indication that Sama Mantra must be chanted only in the morning. The Rishi is indicating. Sama Mantra chanted and Vidhi also is given. And Acharya Shankara gives, why in the morning only to be chanted? He says, Acharya gives an explanation here in this Bhashya only. Says, Devatas who are invoked are Varuna, Prajapati, Surya Bhagavan, Aditya, etc. are invoked because all of them give. And he says, Surya Narayana only is having all these names because he alone does all these works in different forms. Like Varuna, Surya, Prajapati, etc. So, Acharya Shankara says, main devata is here going to be Surya devata. Because Surya only we are invoking, who is, takes different forms and blessing the, blessing us with rain, plenty of cultivation, food, etc. But important is Surya devata. And Surya devata is supposed to be the giver of prosperity of annam, anna samruddhi, Surya Narayana. That is why another name for Surya is Vaji. Vaji means what? Vajani vasvamrutamasvi dravinagam savarchasam. It is Sumed, Trishankor, Vedan, all those things in comes in Taittiriya Upanishad. Vaji is annam. So Surya Bhagavan, Vaji is giver of the annam. Now, so Sam Mantra is actually that somebody says, no, rain may cause, rain only gives annam. But rain also is caused by Surya Narayana only. So therefore, here Sama Mantras are generally chanted. So the dog asks, Mukhya white dog asks other dogs, come tomorrow morning. And it has to be chanted because it is to be invoking the Surya Narayana. Facing Surya Narayana and chanting this mantra is possible only in the morning. In the afternoon, you cannot face Surya Narayana. Evening also it becomes a sunset. So early morning, this Sama Mantra should be chanted sitting in the east, facing towards the east, early morning. This mantra to be chanted for Anna Samruddhi. Okay? Now, and this Bakarushi student, he overheard the conversation. These puppies are asking the white dog, please sing Sama Mantra, we get annam. And the dog said, tomorrow morning you come, we'll meet in the same place, we'll turn towards east and chant mantra. All those things were given. The dog did not say we'll chant towards east and all. Acharya Shankara gave bhashya for it. So next day morning, Baka also went to the same place to listen what is the dialogue, what is it they sing. So Guru dog and Shishya dog, they sing that Sama Mantra. And how they sang, this also is said here. These dogs are all moving in a circle. And the tail of the dog, front dog, is held by the mouth of the previous dog. And they are going in a circle while chanting. The front dog is chanting, all the dogs are holding, and then they are going round behind the front dog in circle. So this is how they are chanting. And this is called Vedic particular mantra, is known as Bahishpavamana mantra. When this is chanted, Samagaha move, they move in circle. Samagaha, they Samagaha chanting, if they chant this mantra, they should move in circle and chant this mantra. Okay, and what was the content of this mantra? This is the said in 5th sloka. What is the mantra they chanted? Om Adama, Om Pibama, Om Devo Varuna Prajapati Savita, Annamiha Ahara, Annapate, Annamiha Ahara, Ahara Om Iti. This could be the, this is the mantra. If anybody poverty, even to go to destroy the poverty, for plenty of food also, this mantra if somebody chants, and everything facilitates. How by chanting mantra we get food? Because by chanting mantra, all the things which are required for food to reach you, all those favorable conditions will be created. If the rain is to be created, rain will come. Sakala Varsha will come. And Akala Varsha will stop. So, this is the mantra. So, what is the meaning here? They are singing this song. That, what you call? Sir, please give us food. Let us eat plenty of annam. And let us not starve. Let us not find any difficulty for annam. Annam, Om Adama, Om Pibama. Let us have plenty of drinking also. Anna Ahara, let food also come to us towards Annapate, Anna Ahara, O Annapati, Annapati Surya Narayana, please give us plenty of food. And also make us hungry also. Annamaya ahara ahara om iti. And therefore, this is also very beautiful prayer. Let us not starve. Let us not find any difficulty for annam. And also give us hunger also. Without hunger, what is the use? So everything, this is the upasana for annavan annado bhavati. Now the prayer, the phalam is also given. That the phalam is that annavan annado bhavati. This adama, all those prayer is there. That gives lot of blessings and annam you will get. This is a prayer. Like similarly asking, you know, oh God, give me a daily bread. Similar prayer, similar to this prayer, daily bread. This prayer is very good, so that anna samruddhi will take place. Anna samruddhi takes place, you can also gift also, dana dharma kar sakte hain. This mantra is very powerful. So this is the in the form of Sama Veda chanting. With this 12th section is called Sauva Gita is completed. Okay, Palashruti is what? Anna Samriddhi. Now we will go to the last section of the first chapter. In the last section we will see another upasana with a different alambanam. Alambanam means support. So far, whatever we saw upasanas earlier, we took the, in majority of cases, support of Udgita. Is it not? In Udgita only we invoked varieties of devatas. Okay. Now, Udgita is Samaveda, Omkara occurring in Samaveda. So, in this section, we are going to take another part of Sama Mantra called Sthobaha. Sthobaha. Please, even if you don't understand our practice, but understand the Vedic glory. How much wisdom, how much Vidya we developed in those days, and now which we have lost in practice. Sthobaha. Sthobaha here means what? It is used for Sama only, which means Stoba means actually, which is a sound symbol. Stobaha means what? A sound symbol, which are used purely only in chanting. For chanting purposes only, these special sounds are uttered. They don't have any meaning. They don't have any particular purpose also. In the sentence, if you see, you find there is no meaning in it. But they have their own effects. For particular effects are there, produced. So these are used in, like in Kathopanishad, we find Ushan Havaya, Ushan Havai Vajashravasaha. Mantra it comes. Ushan Havai, Ha Vai Vajashravasaha. Here Ha and Vai, they have no meaning. They are called Stoba, like Stobaha. In Taittiriya Upanishad also, Hasmava Apyosra Vayetya Shra Vayanti. Hasma Va Apyesra Apyosra Vayetya Shra Vayanti. These words, Hasma Ityadi, they are particles. They are like, there is no meaning in it. Similarly, in Sama Veda mantra, there are so many stobhas, special sounds, they are uttered. And they are totally 13 of them are taken in this chapter. 13 stobhas. And on each stobha, one devata is invoked. Stobaha. Okay, now here one devata is invoked. Now when we read this, it looks actually for us funny. The special sounds, no meaning, some devatas are invoked. For us it looks, because you know, we don't have any touch with Veda, and Sama Veda we never have any touch in particular. and how they practice these shabdas, for what purposes, the effects of sound, that entire vidya is lost. I read in one book long back, it's an authentic book only, not altu faltu. One word, one shabda was typed there. And the yogini, yogini, great yogi, in that book it is mentioned, if you utter this word with a particular frequency, the person who is nearer to you, when few feet away, he will immediately die. In Bhagavatam also we saw, Rishi Hunkara ke saath hi kisi raja ko maar deta, die. No, don't worry, I don't know that. But actually when I read long back, when I was studying degree or something, that book I read, so I also started practicing with different tones and for long time. Cheat bhi nahi mara. Then I said it is a totally secret vidya. Unless Guru teaches you, you cannot, that word, you know, I practice for some time. Let me see when nobody is there around. When I was worried also. Pass mein koi to mar gaya to. Parivar ke sabhi log bhi. So therefore sadasya. So I said I will chant alone when nobody in the house. So there was something, let me see who will die. Nothing, nacha machar bhi nahi mara. Then I understood the sounds are so particular, so clear, and if you chant in a particular way, it has its own effect. And with the shabda, if you master, with the mantra and one simple shabda, you can invoke a devata, and devata will become prachaksha to you. There is a power that devata becomes, what do you call, she has known that devata will not have any other chance except to appear before you, because you pulled that devata with that mantra, with that shabda. So these are all secret vidyas only, Chandogya Upanishad. But stobhas are given. So what is this stobha? So it is not meaningless and all that. They are symbols, sound symbols. Like we say, you know, Ganapati trunk, right side is one symbol, left side is one symbol. Lakshmi, standing Lakshmi is one symbol, sitting Lakshmi is for one symbol. Is it not? Like you see so many symbols you say. So they have its own significance. Images, significance is there in images. Similarly, significance in sounds. So, all those things, there are 13 sthobas are given in 4 mantras. So, we should not criticize them, the Vedic mantras and all that. Ayam vava loko haukaro, vayuhu haikaraha, chandrama athakaraha, atma ihakaraha, agnihi ikaraha, adityo ukaraha, nihavaha ekaraha, vishve devaha auhoyikaraha, prajapatihi hinkaraha, pranaha swaraha, annam ya vak virat anirukta trayodashaha stobaha sancharo hunkaraha dugdhasmai vagdoham yo vacho dohaha annavanannado bhavati ya etameva gamsa samnam upanishadam vedo upanishadam veda. Now these are stobhas or stama only, and in second chapter we will see total sama, entire the sama avayavas completely we will see in second chapter. How many are there? What are they and all? Now see, in the first four mantras, they give a list of 13 devatas and 13 stobhas. First devata, then stobha. Who is in charge of devata and what is the stobha on which this devata can be invoked? Hinkaraha, hunkaraha, all those shabdas only. Now see, in the first mantra, we have 5 devatas and 5 stobhas. Okay? And what are they? First devata. And first devata is mentioned. Then stobha is mentioned. Now, ayam lokaha means prithvi devata is haukaraha is stobaha. Prithvi devata, ayam lokaha means prithvi lokam. Which is devata? Haukaro stobaha. Haukara is stobaha. Haukara. Then Vayu Devata should be meditated upon Hayikaraha. Chandrama should be meditated upon Athakaraha. Here Hayikara is a stobha. Athakaraha, stobha. Atma ihakaraha, stobha. Agni ikaraha, another stobha. Adityo ukaraha. Aditya is, in second month there are 7 devatas are given. Adityo ukaraha. Ukaraha is the stobha. Then nihavaha ekaraha. Nihavaha means avahanam, invitation. So invitation of various devatas used to be done in, this is nihavaha devata, and ekaraha is stobha. Vishve devaha auhoyi, auhoyi stobha. Karaha is the word, not this thing. Auhoyi stobha. Auhoi for Vishve Devatas. Prajapatihi Hinkaraha. Prajapati Devata Hinkara is Stobaha. Then Pranaha Swaraha. For Prana, Swaraha is Stobha. Stobaha. Annam Ya. Ya is again Stobaha. Then Vak Virat is the Stobaha. Virat is a Devata and Vak. Here Ulta ho gaya. Here vak is not a word. So vak is the stobaha and virat is the devata. We have just used reverse. Okay. So virat is the devata, vak is the stobha. So first we saw 5, second one 7. How many? 12. How many I told stobhas? 13 were there. Out of which 12 we saw. In the third mantra, one more devata and stobha are mentioned here. What is the third mantra? See, aniruktaha trayodashaha, indefinable, one who cannot be spoken about, and is the 13th one. That is one stobha. Sancharaha, hunkaraha is the stobha. Devata is aniruktaha. The devata is aniruktha means he cannot be spoken about. That devata. So Acharya Shankara says, Anirukta Sanchara is a Devata. One who continuously Sanchara, but Aniruktaha. We can't be spoken about him. That is a Devata. So Acharya Shankara says, here Anirukta or Anirvachaniyaha. Meaning what? Sanchara means movement. Okay. So material movement is a meaning. In Karya Jagat, in constantly the Karyam is moving. Right? This is the movement, and Ahunkara is the stobha. But what is the deity here? Deity, Bhagavan Shankaracharya says, Maya Sahitam Brahma. 13th stobha is that Hunkaraha. Devata is indefinable, man anirvachaniyam, meaning is none other than Parameshwara only. Ishwara alone is the Devata. Why? Ishwara alone is not definable. Because everybody has specific forms, but Ishwara has no form. He can take any form, any time, and he can dissolve that form. He has no particular form, Ishwara. Devatas have, we saw earlier, a fixed form, all those things, fixed powers. But Ishwara, he can't be defined. So any time, there's a beautiful shloka a Mahatma quoted, is about Lord Shiva. So they say in Shastras, you know, we don't define Ishwara because he is indefinable. He can take any form and he can appear in any way. So there's a beautiful shloka. Tava tattvam na janami kidrushi maheshwaraha yadrushosi mahadeva tadrushaya namo namaha. He says, very beautiful, somebody said, tava tattvam na janami. I don't know your tattvam. Kidrushi. What is, how are you? What is actually your gunaganas? Which form you take, in which watch form you are available, I don't know. Kidrushi Mahad Maheshwaraha, I don't know. But anyway, Yadrushosi Mahadeva, in whatever way you are, to that form, my felicitations. Tadrushaya Namo Namaha. See, whatever form you are in, to that form, I offer my salutations. Okay, so now the mantra 4 is giving Palashruti of the 13 stobhas, devatas and stobha. If you invoke particular devatas in each stobha, right, what happens with the particular chanting of Samaveda Vidhi mantra, if you chant properly, those devatas will bless you. What is the palams? 3 palams are given here. First one is, Acharya Shankara in the mantra says very clearly, that first one is that nice speech you get it. You can refer the first chapter, third section, 7th mantra, 1.3.7. What was the phalam there? Dohaha, milk, you know, the speech is milked by the speech itself. That is the phalam was given for that. And same phalam is mentioned here. So what is that? Nice speech. And nice speech brings all auspiciousness. If you know how to talk, that makes any great problem also can be solved by your very nice talk. Anything is achieved through nice speech, it is said. So that phalam is, you will get nice speech. Speech is milked. By what? By whom? Speech only. Speech alone milks the speech. That was a scene we saw as a phalam. And same phalam is mentioned here also. This sthobha upasaka will get that phalam. Second phalam is annavan annado bhavati. Think. He says, lot of food he will get. Annavan annado bhavati. Dekho. Annavan annado bhavati. Yayetamevagam samnam upanishadam vedopanishadam veda. Now, third one is also good hunger also he gets. So these are the 3 phalams you get. So in this chapter, in the first chapter of Chandogya Upanishad, we saw sama avayavas, right? Upasanas on the sam mantra, udgita and stoba are mainly avayavas we saw, right? And in second chapter, we will see complete sama, sama in total, that we will see. So total sama will become alambanam for various upasanas, which will be mentioned in the second chapter of Chandogya Upanishad. With this, we have completed the first chapter of Chandogya Upanishad, which has 13 sections or khandas. Okay. Om Tat Sat. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om Satgurunath Maharaj Ki.